Good afternoon, my name is Ryan Kimura. I'm the Director of Programs here at the Japanese Culture and Community Center in Northern California. I'd like to welcome you all here to the center for Dr. Shigeki Miyamoto's lecture, Saving the Lives of Animals in the Fukushima Evacuation Zone. It was only almost about 1 year ago on March 11th that the JCCNC created the Northern Japan Earthquake Relief Fund, also known as NJERF. And with that fund, we've been able to raise over $4 million, and that money has gone to help nonprofits in Japan, as well as send a delegation led by Christy Yamaguchi with the Project Aloha. And also, it has enabled us to provide the program today. During the fundraising telethon, it was pretty funny, during the NJERF fund, there were many callers who called in and pledged in honor of their pets, and we all here at the center thought that was really cool. And it's pretty appropriate that we have Dr. Miyamoto here today. And before we bring up Dr. Miyamoto, we would really not be fortunate enough to have this event without the help of the Hachiko Coalition. And so, I'd like to thank and welcome Ms. Alma Cruz, who is the Vice President of the Coalition. Ms. Cruz.
Trespassing, basically, to feed the animals, and thousands of animals survived. I don't know the exact numbers, but maybe Doctor does. The many pets that were there, they did get rescued at the beginning. Then later on, when the zone shut, it diminished because of just numbers. They were dying off. People kept feeding them, and they, some of them did survive. But again, it could have been a lot more had something been done at the beginning. Then later on, as the months passed by, civilians kept feeding them. In particular, we work with a lot of rescue groups on the ground. The Hoshi family has been very active, feeding animals constantly since the disaster, and they're just volunteers. We raise funds through different ways, fundraising. We turn around and give those funds to the animal groups that need food and supplies, vet care. Right now, vet care is a very big thing. Many of the animals have been hurt, and they're very expensive. We need to find a way to bring some care to the animals, and also to keep feeding the shelters that need the food so much. There's hundreds of animals. The shelters try to get the animals adopted, and they're doing a pretty good job. We want to adopt them within Japan, so they don't have to travel 13 hours in a plane somewhere to be adopted. Although maybe with time, it may be possible to bring them somewhere else. At the end of December, the Japanese government let people into the zone, people that were part of rescue groups with permits, and they were able to go in there and rescue animals, and more animals came out. There's still thousands of animals left, cats and dogs that have bred, and there's new life, there's puppies, there's kitten litters. And our goal is to keep raising awareness through media and also fundraising and our contacts in Japan. Everyone that we have worked with has been really supportive, and we're really fortunate to have Dr. Shigeki Imamoto today, and he comes all the way from Nara Prefecture. He has a veterinary clinic, and he's been very vocal and instrumental in getting the word out about that really his own. Originally, when he started going out to Fukushima, his mission was to go check on the dogs and the cats. But he realized that the livestock were the ones being left behind. The livestock were heavy. They couldn't be easily moved. And today, he'll tell you about his experience. Thank you.
はい、どうも、こんにちは、今本です。始めさせていただきます。
はい、my name is 今本。I will be leading now。
まずこれが、入ってはいけない警戒区域の中で僕が撮ってきた写真です。
So here are the pictures that I took in the no entry zone。
今日はこういう写真たくさん使っていきます。そして、僕が撮ったビデオでの動画たくさん流します。
So today I'll be showing a lot of these pictures and also videos that I took.
すごく悲しいシーン、見るに耐えないシーンがあると思いますけど、これが現実なんです。
There are going to be images and videos where it might be very saddening to watch, but this is the reality.
地震の被害に遭った人たちが実際に見るのと同じのを今日は見ていただこうと思います。
Today I hope to show you guys what the people in the area are actually seeing.
もともと僕は奈良県で新庄動物病院というのをやってまして、もともと診察をしているのは犬と猫です。
So normally I have my own hospital in Nara Prefecture. My specialty is with cats and dogs.
そして、何年か前から動物愛護の連載を獣医師向けに獣医の雑誌でやってました。
In recent years, I've been starting to, in an editorial, I guess, presenting the love for animals.
それがあって、今回の、犬と猫以外にも牛とか豚とか含めて、すべて命の問題と捉えて活動をしております。
And with all that into consideration, I believe, or I am working under the assumption that all living things are equal.
そして、僕3月11日、実は奈良県にいなくて、東京の方で地震に遭いました。
Actually, in March, I wasn't in the Fukushima or Nara Prefecture, but I was in Tokyo working.
実はね、地震があった場所はここなんですね。
So that area is where the actual earthquake occurred.
そこからしばらくしてからもう一つ大きい地震がここであったんです。
And after a while, there was a second earthquake on that second location.
それ以降一日何回となく地震がこの辺り全てで揺れてます。
And ever since then, in between those areas, there are many, many earthquakes.
僕たちは地震にあってそこから電車の中だったんですけど、3時間閉じ込められました。
And when the earthquake struck, I was in the train, but was trapped in there for 3 hours.
そして電車の線路ですね。線路を歩いて最寄りの近くの駅まで避難しました。
And I had to walk on the rails to the nearest station to that gate.
で、このように避難をするときに皆さんじゃない、高校生とかがこう自分のカバンを置いて会社の人を助けてるんです。鉄道会社の人を助けて、みんなが助け合ってるんです。
And during the process, even all the high school students put their bags down and were helping each other, all the workers and such. That good.
そして僕、電車の中にいるときに連絡があったんですけど、仙台空港が水に浸かったというふうに連絡を受けたんですね。
And I received a message while I was trapped in the train that the Sendai airport was flooded with water.
仙台空港この辺りです。
Sendai is in that area?
海岸から2キロのところに仙台空港はあります。
Sendai Airport is actually 2 kilometers away from the shores.
そこが津波に襲われたのが地震が起きてから45分経ってからです。
It took 45 minutes only for that area to get flooded.
みんな油断してたんですよね。
Everyone was not really ready for it.
このような津波というのは皆さん想像もしてなかったです。
No one ever assumed or expected a tsunami of that degree to be hitting.
そして、まあこれは片付けられた後の写真ですけど、もう街の中がすべて瓦礫の山になってます。
That's a picture of after everything was cleaned up, but the whole city is in debris.
そして翌日、次の日からはもう食べるものも買うことができなくなって、ガソリンもなくなりました。水もなくなりました。
And ever since the next day, there are no more food, water, or gasoline.
これが福島第一原発なんですね。もともとはこういう形でした。
So that's the Fukushima 第一 nuclear power plant. And the bottom picture was the original image.
そして現在はこのようになってます。
And that is the current image.
誰が見てももう何もない状態ではないというのは分かってもらえると思います。
Anyone can see and notice that there's nothing.
僕がじゃあ福島に行こうと思ったのには理由があるんですけど、まず4月になってから僕はもうボランティア登録をしてました、獣医師として。ただ国の方からもボランティアで行きませんかの話が来てないです。
So there's a reason why I decided to go to Fukushima in the first place. Already in April.I've been trying to volunteer, but there was never an offer from or a request from the government asking for volunteers.
そして4月22日から警戒区域になって人が入れなくなるという知らせを受けましたので、その前に何かできることはないかと思って警戒区域に入りました。
And I was told that after April 22nd.That there is going to be a no entry zone within the 20 kilometer radius. So I figured there must be something I could do before that no entry zone is established.
そして中に入ってみたときに、そこに避難して帰ってる人が言ってたんですけど、空き巣が多いというふうに言われました。
And when I entered it, I was told by the people from there that there's a lot of theft in the houses.
どれぐらい空き巣が増えたのかというと、ここ見てもらうと岩手、宮城、福島なんですけど、数でいうと 109% なんですね。
So if you look at the percentages of the theft over there, Fukushima is at 109.1%.
で、これは警戒区域の中に限って言うと、去年の30倍に増えてます。
And just speaking in terms of the no entry zone, it's 30 times the amount from last year.
まあ、現地の人から言わせると、もうすぐに帰れる、先ほどの話でもありました、すぐに帰れるという言葉を信じて、そのまま避難してきたんです。その隙を突かれて、これだけ盗まれました。そして、いまだに帰れてないところがほとんどです。
So, people were told that they'll be able to return right away. So, they left everything and they left. And during that time, a lot of their stuff were stolen.
警戒区域に入るところには、このように検問がされています。
There's a barricade at the entrance to the no entry zone.
住民であっても中には入れてもらえないです。
You can't even go in, even if you're a resident of the area.
特別な許可がない人はどんな理由があっても中には入れないです。
Unless you have a special permit, there is no way you'll be able to enter.
これが警戒区域の中です。逃げようと思っても車は穴にはまり、そしてこの家、地震の時に倒れたのではなくて、それから後にたくさん揺れた余震で倒れています。
So, this is the image of the no entry zone. Even if you want to run away with a car, you're just going to get stuck in a hole. And the house on the bottom left, that wasn't actually destroyed by the initial earthquake, but it gradually became like that after the many earthquakes.
これが原子力発電所から6キロぐらいのところの町の中です。泥棒は盗みやすそうでしょう。
So this is the area 6 kilometers away from the nuclear power plant. It's very likely for a theft to go in.
このように、病院から薬が盗まれたという話もあります。
There are many stories of... So that's a hospital. There are many stories of medicine and such being stolen from there.
福島以外でも実はたくさん被害が出たところがあるんですね。これは宮城県仙台市と名取市の間にある交差点でのお話です。
So there are many other places besides Fukushima that got affected. This is a crosswalk, or intersection in the Miyagi prefecture.
この道はここの交差点ですけど、ここから山に逃げる道が一本しかなかったんです。
So from that intersection, there's only one road that leads to the mountains where people could evacuate to.
その道の先で一台の車が止まりました。
But at the very end of it, one car failed.
交差点で警察官が車を叩きながら早く逃げるんだっていう話を繰り返したんです。でもみんなほとんど逃げなかった。
And at that intersection, the cops were knocking on everyone's window, telling them to evacuate, but most people didn't listen.
どうなったかというと、その交差点の写真がこれです。
So what happened is, if you could look at that picture down there, that is the image of the intersection.
このように高いところに登った70人は助かりました。
So the people who evacuated to the higher places, where you can see,around 70 people were saved.
そしてここで警察官たくさん犠牲になっています。最後までドアを叩き続けて誰かを助けようとしていました。
And there are many police officers who were affected by it because they were trying to save people until the very last minute.
本当に地震の時には地震だけで死ぬんじゃないんですよね。
So,in a time of earthquake, it's not just the earthquake that causes that.
これは、8月に発表された岩手、宮城、福島の死亡者が何で死んだかなんですけど、92.5% が水死です。
So in August, there was the statistics of how people died and how many. 92.5% were actually drowned.
これ警戒区域の中の写真になりますけど、左上の写真、これは駅です。
So these are also images within the no entry zone. The top left picture is the train station.
そして漁船が野原の真ん中に打ち上げられています。
And that is a fishing boat that's been carried all the way to the middle of the field.
そして 田んぼがもう海水に浸かってますので、もうここは田んぼや畑としての再生は難しいです。
And that's an agricultural land right there, on the bottom right. It's completely filled with seawater, so it's probably almost impossible to recover.
まず僕、4月15日、20キロ圏内に入って、最初に出会ったのがこの馬の農家のおじさんです。
So on April 15th, when I first entered, the first person I met is the person on the top right, who is a horse breeder.
本当に津波が来て、馬のいるところがこれだけ破壊されてるんですね。
The tsunami just destroyed that whole area on the top left, which is where the horses live.
この牛舎から海の方を見るとこうなってます。もう津波が来てここに流されてきた木がいっぱいあります。自衛隊の車が一生懸命この泥を避けてくれている、そういう光景がありました。
From there you can see the bottom left one, picture. It's an image of the self-defense military clearing up the whole debris.
この男性は片道100キロを毎日馬に餌と水を買うためにこの小さいトラックで通い続けています。
The person on the right, top right, he actually drives 100 kilometers every single day so that he could gather food to feed his horse.
だからまあどうしたらいいのかって考えて、この人ですね、南相馬の桜井市長、この市長に僕は会いに行きました。
So, yes, the mayor, the city mayor,
桜井、
Mr. Sakurai, and since they got together to discuss what we could do.
で、それに協力してくれたのがこの高村勤という衆議院議員です。
ハウスオブスネークス、ミスター勤高村、コングレスマンディーです。
He came.
で、そこで5月3日になって馬を出していいことになったんです。警戒区域から。そこまでは法律、国の通達があって、20キロの中から家畜と言われる動物は出してはいけないというふうになってました。
So on May 3rd, it was announced that the horses could leave. But until then, by law, the livestock within the 20 kilometer radius were not allowed to even leave the area.
その時にもう地震から1ヶ月、2ヶ月ぐらいが経過してるんですけど、スクリーニング検査したんですね。どれぐらい被曝してるかやったんですけど、結果はゼロ、問題なしです。
That's May 3rd, that's already been maybe around 2 months after the actual earthquake. And they had a screening to see how much radiation these horses were affected by. And the results showed zero.
じゃあなぜこの馬が警戒区域から出せたのか。理由は3つです。
Public use. They are notuse as food, public facilities will take responsibility.
この3つの理由があれば、警戒区域からでも家畜は出せるんです。
So the only reason why these horses, were able to leave were because of those three reasons. Public use, they are not used as food, and public facilities will take responsibility.
実は南相馬市にとって馬という生き物はものすごく特別なんですね。なぜかというと、こういう相馬野馬追というお祭りがあるんです。
So, to the city of 南相馬、horses are very valuable because they have a cultural event where they use these horses.
一日に27頭の馬を警戒区域から出すことになったんですけど、それを聞きつけて地元のメディアがこれだけ集まったんです。
In one day, there was a process to take out 27 horses, and the local media who heard about it, that's the amount that gathered to check in.
さて、じゃあ次に僕が警戒区域に入る前に日本の農水省、獣医師会、全部に連絡したんですけど、警戒区域の中には実は誰も入ってなかったんです。
So before I entered the no entry zone, I contacted all the government agencies, and none of them actually entered to have a research there.
そこで僕が言われたことは、1ヶ月も人が餌をやらないと生きていけない動物は 餓死してるでしょうって言われました。これは非常にショックでした。
I was told that、if the livestock that can't live without、one month of having people feed them、most likely they're all dead from starvation。
だから僕が警戒区域に入ってこの光景を見たときは驚きました。
So when I entered the no entry zone and saw this view of all these living cows, I was very astonished.
ここの農家の人は警戒区域の裏の道から入って堂々と餌やりをしてました。出るときはわざと検問から出て俺を捕まえてみろって言ってました。
So the farmers who own these cattle, they actually took a back route to go back into the no entry zone and feed the animals. And they even exited from the barricade zones.Kind of intimidating the people trying to catch me.
堂々と餌を、まあ、やってたんですけど、この人は自分のお金で餌をやって、大きなトラックで餌をやって、しかも一人で今でも上げ続けてます。
So this person has been using his own money to feed these cattle, bringing in a huge truck.
さて、5月に行った時に、5月に行った時に、まあ、こうやって水をあげたんですけど、さて、皆さん、この水は危険だと思いますか？
So, this is a video、I took in May,、and I was giving the waters to these cattle. Do you guys think that this water is legal?
ソーラーパワーで汲み上げてますので、地下14メートルから汲み上げてる。
So the water is actually、pumped from 14 meters below the ground, and it's used,、solar power is used to pump the water up.
これは調査したんですけど、14メートルまでは放射性物質は入りません。だからミネラルウォーターと同じで、僕もここに行くたびにこの水は飲んでます。
So,I did research, and the radiation does not reach 14 meters below the ground. And that means that this water is the same as the mineral water you would drink in a bottle of water. So whenever I go back, I drink this same water.
正しくね、検査をして、正しい知識を持って接していかないと、放射能を過剰に怖がるっていうふうにもなります。
Unless you actually do your own research and、gain knowledge,of how these things work, you're going to be afraid of radiation.
じゃあここからちょっと死体の写真がたくさん出てきますので、辛い人はそっと下を向いてください。
From here, we're going to have images of、dead animals. So if you guys are disturbed, just please look down.
先ほどの牧場からすぐ近くに行って農家の人が帰ってこれなくなった牧場です。4月に行った時に生きているのは 40% でした。
So here's the,、the animals in the no entry zone、when I went in April, the percentage of living、animals living were 40%。
実はボランティアの人たちが餌をあげて生かしてたんですよね。
What happened actually was the volunteers were feeding these animals.
遠いところから餌を買ってたんです。
They were buying, food from very far away.
なぜかというと地震後道は壊れて輸送手段がなくて、他にもたくさん必要あの飼料を必要としている農家がありましたので、この辺り周辺は餌がなくなってきてました。
So,This whole area, the roads were already、messed up, and then the local farmers around also needed materials. So a lot of the resources were getting scarce.
なんとかして農家の人たちがね、見たときにショックを受けないで牛を生きて残そうとしたんです。
So the volunteers wanted to save the animals so that when the farmers come back and see、their farms, they won't be shocked by all the dead animals.
しかし入れなくなってしまって4月22日に入れなくなってそこから2ヶ月後こうなります。見てもらいます。
So I'm going to show you、what it turned out like after the 2 months、when the no entry zone was established。